Hi, my name is Charlie. In this video, we'll learn about Package.xml file. Plugin packaging is used to package OpenTAP plugins, libraries, and dependency files for distribution. The Package.xml file created by the SDK, which is the essential file in plugin packaging, where the content and properties of the package is described. Let's open our sample OpenTAP project in Visual Studio and go to Package.xml. Within this package element, there is name attribute, which defines the name of the tap package, and version attribute, which defines the version of the tap package. OS attribute is used to filter packages, which are compatible with the operating system the package manager is running on. We can have both Linux and Windows, or if we need only Windows, then we can specify only Windows here. The architecture attribute defines the CPU architecture. Next, description element can be used to write a short description about the plugin. Files element contains the files that should be included in the release package, so it has our generated DLL. This is the DLL that is going to be packaged together. Inside file element, there can be three attributes. First, path. This is relative to the root of the OpenTAP installation directory. It serves as both source where the packaging tool should get the file when creating the package, and target where the file should be located when installed. The next attribute is source path, which is an optional attribute. It is a path from which the packaging tool will get a file when creating the package. The third attribute is license required, which is also optional. It is for information only and is not enforced by OpenTAP. The file element can optionally contain custom elements supported by OpenTAP packages. For any given element within this package.xml, there are other optional attributes. You can refer to them in the schema using this link given in XMLNS attribute. In the Visual Studio, change the build option to release mode and build the project. After this, you should see a new release folder being created inside your bin folder. In this folder, we can see the tap package. The project generated using SDK comes with a default package.xml. By configuring the project to have release build, the package, in my case, sample package.tap package will be created. In the release folder, you will find the sample package.tap package. Your plugin is ready to be distributed to others using this file. Let's summarize what we have learned today. We have learned about the purpose of package.xml, how to configure it, and finally, how to build tap package. That's all for this video. Enjoy OpenTAP.